I don't know about this stuff about bad growth and stuff like that. You understand what I'm saying? They say, oh, they growing too fast. That's bad growth. No, the church should grow. We have an example of how. 5,000 stones in one set. That's not bad growth. Amen. That's good to be able to witness and to win souls. That's the obligation of the church. Right? And he promised us the power. He promised us the authority. He promised us the ability to influence the world. But ye shall receive power. My God. After that, the Holy Ghost hath come upon you. And so he has come to make our witnessing effective. Tell somebody we should be effective. We should be effective. Tell somebody else we should be effective. Amen. Amen. We should be effective. So we see the church growing. And it's growing like wildfire. It's spreading throughout the known world. And as the church begins to increase, the number of the Jews began to decrease. And so the leaders of the Jews don't like the fact that the church is growing. So they try first to disbelieve them. And so when they would see them healing in the name of the Lord, like that man that they brought to the gate and left him there every day. And so when they went and they healed the man, and he no longer needed to ask for alms. So let me ask this, what's wrong with healing? What's wrong with healing? What's wrong with deliverance? What's wrong with deliverance? Now, in our church, we used to didn't take medicine. Y'all remember that day? Amen. We'll take a pill for a headache. We'll take nothing, but also nothing. You hear me? Because we believe God will heal. Well, those days are gone by. Now they say we got wisdom. You see what I'm saying? All this stuff. That's cool. I ain't got nothing. If the doctor gave it to you, you follow the doctor. Go ahead. But I believe God for healing. Because there's some things that the doctor is not going to tell me. And he's not going to tell me what time to wake up. And he's not going to tell me what time to go to bed. And he's not going to tell me what to take with it. See, that's what I have Jesus for. The doctor won't be the Lord over my life. I still believe God for healing. I got a witness here. If anybody in this house believes God for healing, come on and put their hands together and thank God, thank God, thank God. And so they decided, in order to put the fire of revival out, that they would beat the disciples. But that didn't work. Because they said, we'd rather obey God than man. And the more they beat them, the more they preach. My God. The more they beat them, the more they cried loud and said not. And so they came up with a new strategy. If beating don't work, let's try killing. My God. Because a dead man can't preach. Amen. Amen. I said a dead man can't preach. Amen. So they took James, the brother of John, and they killed him with the sword. And when they saw that this made the Jews happy, they took Peter also. But the Bible said it was the days of unleavened bread. What a mighty God we serve. You know, God always makes some kind of way out of nowhere. Can I get a witness here? It always falls on the day when it's not convenient for them. My God, we serve a mighty God. He knows how to work things out. The thing that I love about God is that he don't fight man. He get all in the wind. Can I get a witness? He get all in the lightning and thunder. He does things that man just can't do. We serve a mighty God, don't we? Oh God, if I had to know why my boots here, I feel like this now. And so it was
that they had Peter in prison. And that they delivered him to 16 soldiers. They had him locked up. They had stocks on his hand and stocks on his feet. But the Bible said that the saints ceased
pray for him. Don't somebody, don't stop praying. And when I came along in this church, they told me, don't stop praying. The Lord is nigh. Don't stop praying. He'll hear your cry. The Lord has promised, and his word is true. Don't stop praying, and he'll answer you. Can I get a witness here sometimes? Does anybody around here know that God is a prayer answering God? I wish I had a witness. I wish. Anybody here ever cried out to God? I'm talking about when your back was up against the wall. Anybody here ever cried out to God? I'm talking about when it looked like it wasn't going to work out in your favor, but somehow, some way or another, God still came through for you. Can I get a witness that he is a prayer answering God? My God. You remember that woman? The Bible says that she was a widow, meaning that she had no system of care. She had no caregiver, and she had no caretaker. The woman was all alone, but she had an adversary. So she kept going to the judge. But the Bible says that this was no ordinary judge. Say, but the man was unjust. And what we mean by unjust is that he didn't care about God and that he didn't care about man. The Bible says that he was unjust. It just means that he was not righteous. Oh, but the little sister kept knocking on the door. I'm here to tell you that it's something about persistence. Because Jesus said that men are always praying and not him. Tell somebody, don't give up. Tell somebody else, don't give up. Tell one more person, don't give up. Yeah, don't dare to give up, but continue to pray. Because I found out that prayer is the point of prayer is where you release your faith, my God, my God. And prayer is where God releases the blessing. But in order to get the blessing, you're going to have to release your faith, my God. Tell somebody, release your faith. Tell somebody, release your faith. Oh, God. If you want to pray, because prayer works. Now, can I be a witness here? Don't pray. And the Bible says that when Job prayed, the Lord turned again his captivity. And he gave him twice as much as he had before. Abraham prayed for Abimelech, and the Lord healed his wife and his children. Isaac prayed, and the Lord made room for him. Jacob prayed, and the Lord delivered him from the hand of his brother Esau. Moses prayed, and God spared the children of Israel. Hezekiah prayed, and God added 15 years to his life. Israel prayed, and the Lord restored Israel. Daniel prayed, and God shut the mouth of the lion. Lord, as I have a little while, I preach here. Jehoshaphat prayed, and the Lord fought his battle for him. Tell somebody you want to pray more and fight less. Tell somebody pray more and fight less. You see, the more you pray, the more God will fight for you. The Bible says that though Jehoshaphat feared, he set himself, my God. Tell somebody, stop fussing, stop cussing, and set yourself, my God, to seek the Lord. And the Lord heard his prayer, confounded and confused his enemies. And the Lord said to him that you have no need to fight, my God. I love Jesus so near. He said, you have no need to fight in this battle, because this battle is not yours. My God, my God. I'm almost to push it here. I said, this battle is not yours. This is the Lord's battle. Well, I gotta move on now. But the second thing that I wanted to talk to you about
is divine intervention. You know, the thing that I love about God is the fact that God gets involved. Tell somebody, God gets involved. Tell somebody else, God gets involved. Aren't you glad that God gets involved? He got involved when they had thrown Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the fiery furnace. He got involved. You see, the folk that threw them into the furnace, they died. But when the king came down sometimes later, he saw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego walking around loose in the fire. I heard the preacher say they were chilling in the fire. And he said he saw somebody else. And the fourth one that he saw looked like the Son of God. I'm here to tell you that God will never leave you. Can I get a witness here? I'm almost to preach. I said, God will never leave you. And he will never forsake you. Can I get a witness here? He said, he'll be with you in the sixth trouble. And that in the seventh trouble, he will deliver you. But the problem that we face is that we don't want to go through any trouble. You see, God can't deliver you from the furnace unless you first go in the furnace. And the problem with the saints is that because we live right and because we think that we got it going on, we feel that we are above suffering. We feel that we are above pain. We feel that we are above struggle. But the Lord sends here to tell somebody that you'll never know that he'll take the heat out of the fire. If you never go in fire, not quite yet. I'm almost ready. But I came to tell you today that they had a lot to give up, my God. And now God has dispatched an angel from heaven. I don't know about you, but I thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, that we had angels watching over us. I said, I thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, that all night and all day that the angels are watching over us. I thank God that he has a way.